Hello everybody, welcome back to another stream. Make sure you guys visit the website, everydaygamingsociety.com, for all of the content. Give Nasty Civic a follow here on Twitch, like us on YouTube and Facebook, and listen to our podcast.
Again.
What's wrong with him?
You got away from her! Benedicta! give this a try.
Not bad.
We'll be right back.
that you, Ultima? What do you want?
Your soul is tainted with worthless human will, yet your thirst for power remains undiminished. With every sip you take, you grow in strength, and soon you shall achieve perfection.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You will accept us, Muthos. It is inevitable. You were created for this purpose, and you shall serve it.
Never!
You mitigate its weakness by interweaving it with your consciousness. We believed we had merely to purge you of your will to claim our vessel. It appears we first have to sever every thread of the consciousness that supports it. No matter. The time to build a new world is not yet upon us. We will contemplate.
Thank you, Joshua.
One can no more command the power of ether by drowning in its flood than one can constrain the tides by standing in the sea. I had thought Hugo wiser than this, but it seems his head was full of rocks after all.
Titan was strong.
Your Majesty.
But Muthos is stronger. For 5 years, that man lived only for revenge. Clinging fast to a fiction, even as it swept him into the abyss. One cannot change one's nature through force of will alone. Only the Almighty can do that.
Hugo Kupka, the man who gave his life for a woman's head. A fool like all the rest.
The death of a mother crystal should be so beautiful.
Some medicine, my lord? I have salves, potions, anything you need.
Stop bothering me, urchin, or you'll feel the back of my hand.
You must consider your health, my prince. If a show of force is needed to keep the Dalmex at bay, you may trust in your dragoons. I beg you to call on Bahamut only as a last resort. His strength comes at too great a cost.
The Empire agreed to an armistice with the Republic, and yet the Emperor still plots its ruin. For now, the Dalmex suspect nothing. And as long as I can hold their gaze, war need not be inevitable. But more than that, Bahamut is the champion of the Empire. When our people look to the heavens, the sight of him gives them hope. Forgive me, Terence. Would that you were my master. But alas.
I will always be your loyal servant.
Should the Council's brazen maneuvering prompt the Republic to tear up their own treaty and launch a new assault, our soldiers would advance to meet them, cutting across the central aisles, but not in time to prevent their forces from breaching the southern defenses and storming Twinside. And so the capital would become a battlefield. Thousands of innocents would die. I cannot allow that to happen.
There is one small mercy, at least. You will not be forced to do battle with Titan.
Would that I could avoid doing battle at all.
A thousand pardons, Your Highness.
What is it?
Olivier has been made Emperor. What is the meaning of this?
My father's orders. What were they? Quickly! Yes, Your Highness. His Radiance requests that Your Highness maintain position here and...
Gah!
Yes, my prince.
I must go to the palace.
I'll ready your steed.
What is it now?
Forgive the intrusion, Your Highness.
I know you.
At ease.
We stand in the presence of the Phoenix. You wouldn't want to get your fingers burned.
I hope I'm not interrupting.
Not at all. Though I admit, I did not expect such a distinguished guest.
How many years has it been since the Remembrance Ceremony? 20?
I thought you long dead. Do I address a ghost?
Many have told me that I look like one. But no. I'm alive. Just. Prince Dion of the House Lesage, I have a tale to tell you.
better give Otto the good news.
Welcome home, Sid.
Give me 50 good boards, 8 span each.
Gav told me the gentleman who visited earlier, the one with the loud voice, was your uncle. I did think there was a resemblance. Something in the eyes.
Here for another of my lectures.
What is it that you wish to learn?
Study it well, Clive. Very good.
Clive, you're back.
I am. And with glad tidings for once. Hugo Kupka is no more.
Well, I'll be. All of our comrades who lost their lives back at Sid's place be smiling down at you right now.
We had a stallus from Lubor saying Drake's fang had fallen. I expect that was your doing as well, was it?
It's a long story.
One for the history books, I'll bet.
Welcome home, Clive.
It's good to be back. You look better.
I feel it. Which means I'm coming on your next little adventure. You're not leaving me behind again.
Wouldn't dream of it. Otto. Word on the Royalist movements since I've been away.
Shouldn't you be putting your feet up? If you really want to know, go and have a word with Vivian.
Thank you. I will.
If you're desperate to know more about Walud, Vivian's your girl. But if I were you, I'd be heading straight to my bed.
It's good to have you back. I was worried.
Not bad for a boy from the Imperial Barracks, eh?
Ah,
the conquering hero returns. And with hardly a scratch on him.
I may have picked up one or two.
Well, the fact that you came straight to me instead of visiting our resident physica suggests that you picked up something more important. A scent. The scent of Waludas.
The very same. But whatever plans Kupka was hatching with the Royalists, he took them to his grave. As did his men. Slaughtered by the orcs who'd taken over the Fang. Orcs, Vivian. I've never seen such creatures in Storm before. The Waludas must have ferried them over from Ash, but why? Why work to rescue Kupka only to invade his home, the mother crystal of an allied nation, and let both fall? It makes no sense.
Do you know the tale of the blind men and the Adamantus? One can often be led astray by focusing too closely on individual details. One must instead see the bigger picture. And what bigger picture is there than my map? The Kingdom of Walud claims dominion over all of Ash. It is a nation forged by the bloody conquest of Barnabas Tharm, the dominant of Odin. The Canvarian War of Independence in 849. The Battle of the Twin Realms in 865. The Battle of Belinus Tor in 873. Wheresoever his armies fought, Odin was found where the fighting was fiercest. But of late, the warrior king appears to have laid his sword to rest. Battle rages for control of the crystalline dominion. Yet Tharm sends not a single ship in support of his Dalmechian allies. Meanwhile, the blight ravages great swathes of Ash. Yet warlike Walud shows not the faintest interest in laying claim to untouched lands. So why go to the trouble of sending an army of orcs into the heart of Drake's Fang, only to make no attempt to claim the Mother Crystal for Walud? It can hardly be for lack of men. Tharm's armies rival any in the Twins. No. We have not seen the last of the Waluda standard. Odin will ride again. It is but a question of when. And on that day, who will be trampled underfoot? In summary, I know not to what end the Royalists betrayed Kupka. I know only that it is part of some broader scheme. A scheme tied to the ambitions of one man.
King Barnabas.
But there is no need to wallow in confusion. If one is to cure a sickness, one must first identify the symptoms. And your Lord Uncle has volunteered to do just that by keeping an eye on the Royalists' movements.
He's really throwing himself into this.
Indeed he is. Which means all that remains for us to do is await his reports. Well, not quite all in your case. The people of the Hideaway must hear the news. Justice has been done. Hugo Kupka is dead. The wounds he left that night are still raw, especially for those who lived with Sid the longest. Tell them that those wounds might finally begin to heal. Consider it the price of today's instruction.
I've never known you to be sentimental.
What can I say? I am only human. And we are, all of us, sentimental animals at heart.
I suppose we are. Very well. I'll go and spread the word.
Thank you.
And how may I assist you today? Here for another of my lectures? So what if it's Parliament? Which leaves but one man. Harpocrates, Kupka took.
Clive, have you come seeking the gift of knowledge?
No. To share mine, actually. Hugo Kupka is dead.
Oh my. Can it really be true?
Look, he's crying. He is. The big baby.
And with good reason, children. These are tears of joy. We must offer up a prayer to your parents that the heavens might weep with us. There shall be no lessons today, only thanksgiving and merrymaking. Go, put away your things.
All right. Brilliant.
Finally, a new dawn has broken.
It has.
Thank you, Clive. I cannot wait to share the good news.
Harpocrates, after Kupka fell, Ultima came to me. I need to know what he is. Have you learned anything?
Alas, no. And not for want of trying. I have scoured nigh every historical tome in our collection and found nothing. Not even the sort of conspicuous absence that might suggest a concealment of fact. One is almost tempted to conclude that such a creature never existed.
But I saw him. With my own eyes.
I don't doubt that you did. Alas, it seems you are the only one who has. To others, he reveals naught. We see only that which he leaves in his wake. Like some terrible force of nature beyond the ken of mortal man.
A bringer of death.
Whether the Ultima you met with was the being itself, or merely another projection of its power, I know not. But until I do, my investigations shall continue.
Thank you. It means a lot.
How good it is to see you, Clive. I have compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Did you learn everything you needed? My knowledge is yours. Look around. Still, why? I have said it. His story. Were you aware? But what of the... Yes. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. You are always welcome, Clive.
The Lotus Sea who visited.
The man who heard that.
Not bad for a boy from the Imperial Barracks, eh?
Well, someone looks pleased with himself. It's true what I'm hearing, then.
Nothing escapes you, Lady Karen. It's true. Kuka is dead.
No more looking over our shoulders, then. Good. I'm starting to get a crick in my neck. Don't let it go to your head, though.
Is it business or pleasure? Go on, then.
Finished, are you?
I'm telling you, it's true. I heard it from Otto's own lips.
Good girl.
Faster! Come on.
Thanks, girl. Should have stayed in its shell. Good girl. Let's go.
Fly, Ambrosian.
Straight home now. My blade yet hungers, and so do I. Come, let us feast on your flesh. Your feasting days are over. Those who kill for sport deserve no better. Ready, go?
Yeah!
Safe.
mountain of a monster, twice as tall as Titan himself, cracked the fang open like it was a sparrow's egg. I swear, on my grandmother's grave, I saw it myself.
The crystal. The mines. It's all gone.
Lord Kupka's castle too. Do you think he made it out alive?
No need to ride from here.
Ready, girl? Straight home now.
Road is closed. Turn back.
Stranger, wherever you're headed, it's back the way you came.
Faster!
To the stables, girl. This might take a while. Come on. Don't get surrounded. Safe.
Get him! That wasn't too bad, was it, Torgal?
This is no time to ride. Let's go. Right.
Seems this one has a little more life left in it. All right then.
Get him!
What are you after? Not sure you could carry that. There you go. Thanks very much. Much obliged. Thanks very much. There you go. That all, is it?
To the stables, girl.
This one. Attack! Over here! This one.
This one. Now, Torgo! Attack!
I'm telling you, it's true. I heard it.
We're seeing troops amassing at every border crossing.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon. Your benefactors are a generous lot. Here you are. Come again. I may have more for you.
You barely sat down since you came home. Vivian got you running errands or something?
Just spreading the word.
So, the professor's got a soft side, has she? I'd never have guessed.
No. She was right, though. Everyone was glad to hear the news.
Ah, but you ain't told everyone. I can think of plenty of friends back at the old hideaway who'd sleep more peacefully for knowing. Not least of all Sid. You should tell him.
You're right. I should. And I will.
Well, when you do, be sure to take Mid with you. She's been going at it hammer and tong down in that workshop of hers, trying to do her father proud. I can't remember the last time she visited the old sod's grave.
Very well. I'll suggest it.
Don't think Mid's been to visit her old man's grave in years. So take her with you when you go. Let Sid see his daughter's face. If he can recognize it under all the grime.
Fancy a look at the list, do you? Anything catch your eye?
Good day to you.
It's all but spent.
The crystals will get to the
table. We had to dig a new cellar.
Ah, Clive. Your timing is exquisite, as always. I have a concern which you may be able to assist me with.
Go on.
There are whisperings afoot of shadowy figures having been sighted outside the village. Rustlings in the undergrowth, suspicious noises. My people fear that they are being watched. It may be no more than a surfeit of nerves, understandable in the current climate, or it may be the prelude to something altogether more dangerous. Given what I hope you'll forgive me calling your nose for trouble, I wondered if you might investigate.
Of course.
Excellent. You might begin by speaking with the good citizens of Lostwing. Listen to their tales, and make what you will of them.
All right. I will.
Hello, Sid. Take a seat where you like.
Right. Let's see what the people of the village have to say. I'd better find out if this is just nerves, or something we need to take more seriously.
You all right, Sid? Something on your mind?
There is, actually. Can I ask you something? Quentin tells me people have mentioned shadowy figures out in the woods. Have you noticed anything unusual?
Oh, that. No, sorry, can't help you. I heard the rumors, mind, from the lads working over at the vineyard, but none of them has seen anything either.
All right. Thanks anyway.
What? With that rod of yours?
I've caught my share with it.
Do you have a moment? There's talk of suspicious figures in the woods. Have you seen anything out of the ordinary?
No, but I've heard something. Sound of scraping metal, like someone sharpening a sword.
Where was this?
In Lorbert's Pass. Was out foraging for herbs when I heard it. Screeching out from between the trees. Ran back here as quick as my legs would carry me. And I ain't been back since.
I see. I'll look into it. Thank you. Seems Lorbert's Pass is our best bet, then. What do you say, Torgal? Shall we go and investigate? Not here. You there.
Fuck! He's seen us. Get them before they escape!
Black Shields. Here. What the hell are you doing here?
What is it to you?
We give a damn.
All that matters to us is that you don't leave here alive.
This one.
Yes.
Why were they here? Are they planning an attack on Lost Wing? I need to warn Quentin.
Clive, how goes the hunt for our sinister figures?
I found some black shields hiding near Lorbert's Pass. They're gone now.
Black shields. The Empress's former bloodhounds. Though they serve another master now. One who means to root out and destroy both me and those I care for. And it would appear the pack has finally caught the scent of its prey. Damn it all. I had hoped I would have more time than this. More time to prepare. But if we are cornered, we have no choice but to bite back. And bite back we shall.
I'm sorry. You're going to need to explain. Who did the Black Shield serve now? And why would that person want you dead?
Because I want him dead.
Who?
The former Lord Chief Justice of Sanbrek. All that I have built here is for him.
I don't understand. Why him? Why Lostwing?
I suppose it is better that you know the truth. I was a member of the judiciary once. So sickened was I by the injustice of this world, I swore to fight it. And fight it I did in my own small way. I saw more than a few corrupt officials condemned to the very cells into which they had thrown blameless innocents. Men to whom the law was but a scourge to turn against the powerless. And throughout, it was the Lord Chief Justice who backed me, who was my one true ally in the quest to see justice done.
So what changed?
I discovered that he hunted bearers for sport. I was a fool to think he shared my hatred of venality and vice. His support for me was no more than a facade, a means of ridding himself of his rivals, a mask to hide the rot beneath. I filed suit against him immediately. His response, however, was rather more visceral. He had my entire family slaughtered, and he faced no punishment whatsoever. I lost everything. My loved ones, my livelihood, my position, the faith I had once held that any modicum of justice might be achieved through the courts. So I set about enacting my own. I tracked down every soul who served him and slit their throats myself. But the man himself proved an altogether more difficult target. With money and power come protection. And so I saw that I would need an army of my own. I came here to Lostwing and began recruiting like-minded individuals.
And everyone here knows this is why you do what you do.
Of course. They too have lost loved ones to the bearer hunts. Seen faultless friends sent to the gallows to spare the guilty. All under the watchful eye of the Lord Chief Justice.
Like, comment, subscribe, and visit the website, everydaygamingsociety.com, for all of our content and listen to our podcast.